Hello explorers and welcome to another video. And today I'm gonna answer a question that I got in the comment section on one of my videos, Tensorflow with Java. And the question is from Charles Duplessis. Perhaps I'm pronouncing that wrong. He said, "Hey Daniel, would you mind helping me set up a project in Eclipse to get going?" So today I'm going to do a little bit of a very simplified version about how to set up and run your models in Eclipse with Java. So in this case, I expect that you already set up TensorFlow and got the Python part running. If you haven't, then look at my other video, running TensorFlow with Java, or building running models with Java. And if you have your model ready and you want to try it out in Java and run it in your Eclipse environment, the first thing you need to do is to go to the TensorFlow GitHub page, and you go down this page and you find the TensorFlow directory, and in that directory you have Java, and here you have a README which gives you a lot of different information about how to set up different things in Java. And what you want to do is go down this page and find the Quick Start Using Java and Java C and download this lib, a TensorFlow jar file, which is, in my case, 1.1.0RC2. And you also want to download one of these files down here, which are the libraries, the native libraries for TensorFlow. So you have for Linux, OS X, and Windows. In my case, I downloaded Windows. And when you have those on your drive, you should have these files. So here we have my jar file, and I got a zip file for Windows. And in this zip file, I have this tensorflow.jni.dll. So let's go into the Eclipse environment. I have downloaded my Git repository, this tensorflow-mist test, so that you can find on Kalos Puffer's GitHub page. And when you have downloaded that and imported that into your Eclipse, you should have some of these directories. Maybe you don't have everything I have here, because I have ran a different tests and so on, but you should at least have a GNI directory, you should have a source directory, and you should have the run sh to do. You won't have but a README and a POM file and so on. And it might be that you don't have the Maven dependencies that I use, because those I have added to my repository. So what you want to do is to put your libtensorflow jar file somewhere in this project so you can easily find it. And in your JNI directory, you want to put this tensorflow_gni.dll. So those are the important parts to bring into your project. And in order to run this, you take this app jar and you set this up as a runnable app. And the run configuration should look something like this. You have the easy run. In your arguments tab, you will add dash d java.library.path equals /JNI. So you actually tell Java where your native libraries are located on disk. And then you want to go to class path and you want to use the add jars feature. And in your project, you select this jar file as I already done, libtensorflow 1.1.0-rc2.jar. As I have already selected it here, I can't select it again. So if I remove this, add jar, I should see it in the list here. I just click on it and add it up. You apply your changes, and then you run your. You can run this, and you should get this "Hello world, I'm using TensorFlow version 1.1.0-rc1." The errors you can get is either I couldn't find your lib your jar file, or I couldn't find some function in TensorFlow. Then you either have the wrong version, an older version of TensorFlow, or you might have missed to add your dependency for this jar file. You can also get the error that it couldn't find your library, and that's usually that you haven't specified where your native libraries are. So look into the string native library and you should get that error. So we could actually do this here. We could try out and create those two errors so you can see those as well. If we remove this file here, we run this, we will get TensorFlow, in this case, no class definition found, org TensorFlow, TensorFlow is missing. And if I add that back again in my class path, so add this jar file and then go into arguments and just put a 2 in the end of that and run, you get this error: cannot find TensorFlow native library for OS Windows architecture. So you can also perhaps been downloading the wrong version of the TensorFlow. So it actually gives you the link to the Git repository where you can download it. So we will put it that in the right directory. So I hope this information was what you were searching for. And I really hope that you learned something today and that you can run your TensorFlow experiments with ease in Eclipse. If you have any questions or want help with anything else, please leave me a comment and I'll try to answer them again. Perhaps not in a video if it's an easier one. And if I want to do something more visual, I will probably do another video. So I really hope to see you in the next one.